Are you ready for when the lights go out? Lucky for us, Anker has sponsored this video by providing us a portable power station.
If you own an EV, an RV, or you're looking for a backup power solution for your home, and you don't like the sound of noisy generators, then you'll want to join us as we put this thing to the test.
So here it is, the Anker Solex F3800. This thing's a beast. We're gonna see in the middle of winter here in Canada, will this power this 24-foot office, and will it heat this thing? First thing I notice here is this thing's heavy, and so it must have a lot of juice in it. And another way to know why it would power a lot of things is because it's got a 50-amp straight blade plug here or the 30-amp twist lock. So that's half a household. And I guess if you pair two of these together, you can run pretty much everything a house would throw at a circuit breaker and just live your life normally. Especially if you added all the expansion packs, you could do it for a longer period of time during a power outage or who knows what. Let's check it out. So here we are inside of our 24-foot office here. This container office has been utilized lots around our container yard. It's been commissioned at about four different places, and we're able to do that very quickly because we have a twist lock style plug. So this thing can just unplug from power and data, and boom, we hook up to it with a wheel loader, top lift, whatever. We can relocate it around our site. So this is the perfect time for us to test out the Anker Solex F3800. And what we're gonna test is whether it will run all of the functions within the office, and then will it also provide heat? So in this office, we're feeding the power in a 100-amp main breaker on a square D panel. You'll see here that we have two 15-amp, 240-volt breakers feeding the baseboard heaters. But we also have a 20-amp, 120-volt breaker feeding the mini split AC unit. This only needed to be 15 amps because it only draws about 7 amps, but we oversized it there and the wire. But we're going to be able to see exactly how much each individual heater draws on the digital dashboard of this backup power station. We actually need a transfer switch. So outside, we are going to hook the traditional power cable right into the transfer switch, and then from there, we can plug that into either grid power or into this bad boy. We're in tight quarters here because this container is frozen to the ground, so we gotta tackle that next. But we got Travis here, our electrician, and a ghetto old transfer switch that is way oversized, but we're gonna use it. And so this thing here is gonna have the grid power or power from the battery feed into this shipping container. So we're gonna use that, and we're gonna simulate a power outage. And if the power was to go out, we'll flip it, and hopefully everything runs on the shipping container when that's done. So two will be utility, one will be battery. Basically, you'll connect to these lugs for one or the other. And so here we've used our CSM exterior brackets. So these brackets allow us to mount strut channel to the outside of a shipping container. They're a little bit shallower because there's less room here, and so it's a different profile than our interior CSM brackets. And we use those at the bottom and at the top, and now we have two strut channels mounted vertically, and we can hang 1500 pounds on each one of these. There's spring nuts in here ready for this transfer switch to be mounted, and we've measured that and drilled the hole, so we just gotta hold it up and bolt it in. Travis is all finished up wiring the transfer switch here now. So we have our power traditionally coming from the grid, and we have a cord coming into the transfer switch as well, which is gonna plug into this unit here. And then the transfer switch feeds our junction box on this office as we had previously. So I'll grab the cord here. This is the twist lock. So the 25 amp max twist lock. We'll just turn this bad boy on. And then in order to plug this in, we need to go to the EV charging mode, and you do that by hitting this button twice and waiting for the little car to appear. And then you can hear the relay inside this unit kick on. So plug this bad boy in. We are plugged in. Power is off. See what happens. 1672 watts. 1790 1799. This thing's awesome. I think I forgot to turn off all the breakers, so like absolutely everything is running inside this office right now, and it's handling it. This is cool. I didn't know how excited I'd be once I turned that on, but I wanna go check this out. Oh yeah, we left everything on this thing. So that is actually amazing. It wasn't pulling very much. The heater is on and it's tugging. I have the breakers all on for the baseboard heaters. I'm gonna try a little experiment here. So, ooh, this thing's, that's on too actually. And what about this? Oh yeah, so we're running 2000 watts, 1000, this doesn't make sense. It's running all the baseboard heaters, the heat pump. This is crazy. I cannot believe this. Let's go back outside. I wanna see, cause everything's tugging, all the heaters are pulling on this thing. I wanna see how much power it's using. So we got the app here on the phone too, and so you can actually just see exactly what's going on. So on the app, it says 3791, 3877, same thing. So it's real time, it's adjusting. I can see it moving back and forth. So this is super handy. You don't have to be in your mechanical room or your garage where you're storing this thing and be able to read what it's actually doing. But it's pulling a lot of watts, pulling 4,000 watts. We got all the heaters on in here. I had zero faith in this thing to be able to do all that. That is a ton of load. There is serious power in here. I am so impressed. I cannot believe it, but yeah, it's definitely, it's coming to my basement for sure, and it's got my endorsement. I seriously don't believe this. Like, we are actually running everything. All these heaters in here, they don't even turn all on when it's minus 50 out here, and we can keep these guys warm and working all winter long if the power was to go out. I am so impressed. I hardly believe it. I want to just see what the wattage is on these Ouellette heaters. I'm almost certain these baseboard heaters are 1,000 watts each. That's 2,000 watts. This thing must be 1,500 watts. I can actually, 1,500 watts at 240 volts. And then just the computers and everything running in here brings it up to about 4,000 watts that it's pulling on that. But it's a split phase battery, and I believe you get, you know, X amount, half the power on one side and half on the other. So our breaker panel must be relatively evenly distributed. But yeah, no glitches, no flickers, no nothing of the lights. It's just working awesome in here. And so yeah, here you can see 86% already. We've just kind of got rolling here, 85%. And remaining power says about 30 minutes. So it would be for a power outage, or we could be intelligent and turn off some of the heaters. All the, you know, we don't need all these BTUs inside of here. So I don't even know. I think there's a kettle. Maybe we'll try turning on the kettle while we got all this. Here we are, 81% now. Let's turn it on. Because this thing I think was pulling 1,000. Oh yeah, 5,216 watts. That's a ton coming out of that that 25 amp rated twist lock. So wow, I'm just so impressed right now. I cannot believe, I think I said this earlier, but it just makes me giddy. I'm actually super impressed, and I didn't know I was gonna, it's like Christmas morning to me here. This is sweet. I want to turn off all the resistive heating in here, and I can use this app to see exactly how much I am outputting. So I have all of the baseboard heaters off now. I'm only using 167 watts. Now it's saying I got 10 hours and 42 minutes. So here now I turned on the electric baseboard heaters and I'm pulling 1580 watts, and I only have an hour and 20 minutes left. If I turn this off, and when I turn back the mini split unit, it's gonna take a while to spool up, but it'll get to about 900 watts. And as I just saw earlier, it would run for about 2.5 hours. So I can get double the longevity out of running my mini split heat pump. And this thing's pumping out 50% to, you know, 100% more BTUs than just burning an electric baseboard heater. So we've run this thing down to 70%, and it can be charged with either 1800 watts by just plugging it into an AC outlet, or you can use solar. So it takes 2400 watts of solar charging, and it comes with a sweet option for the RVers out there. There's a 400 watt foldable panel in there, and so you can utilize these. They work great for stuffing all this gear right in the underbelly stowage of your RV. And if you have a solar array at home, you can actually just plug in your regular solar panel. So these 540 watt panels, four of these things could fit right into there, and it would charge it in no time. Woo! Big thank you to Anker for sponsoring this video. If you are looking to purchase one of these Anker Solex F3800s, check the link in the description below. I had a ton of fun filming this, way more fun than I expected, and I hope you enjoyed it too. If you'd like to see more cool shipping container modifications, make sure you subscribe for more.